But I really want to talk about the differences between real shapers and other shapers and what to look for when you're buying shapers. These shapers are just a hell of a deal. As I said, my first one was one of these 185 PL. And I really like this machine, although for serious use, I board the table with my driving truck flat. But you want a table you can lean against. You want a machine that isn't going to move and it's secure. The spacing between the bearings and the key peg, whenever you're running these high quality machines, they'll always have more under the table than over the table. And that's a good rule of thumb. It doesn't matter if it's a fan. If what under the table is more than what's on top of the table, you're on the right track. Now, any of these machines will spin a cover up to 8 inches in diameter without too much trouble. You may have a lot more trouble standing in front of it while it's running, but the machine will handle it. This is one we just recently finished work on. Josh put this together. And this is a Whitney 89. And this is really a pretty big wrong sleeper. The table was, I hurt myself trying to set this table up on the board. But I've had people ask me different questions about how these spindles work and how thread-on spindles work. And there's a methodology about putting spindles on and how to make sure your covers and stuff are right. We can talk about that first if you have questions. There's no structure to any of this. I do demos on shapers, not infrequently, for customers and customer plants. The last big one I did was in Costa Rica. Showing the place out there in slaves with Nike doing green hand shaping. If there's any specific questions, maybe we'll start a little later, but just dig in and ask me whatever you want. This this is the inch corner spindle.